Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Libby, and today I'm going to talk about five beauty products that I don't buy anymore. So if you're curious to see what beauty products I don't buy anymore, then keep on watching. I'm going to start with hair care. So there's two hair care products that I used to buy all the time and I don't anymore. So the first one is, drumroll, pea protecting spray. So I used to be obsessed with this particular one by Tresemme. I used to use it all the time. But since the end of 2019, I stopped using heat protectant sprays. That's weird, right? Well, you should be using heat protectant spray because how do you protect your hair from damage? Well, actually, I was talking with my stylist and I kind of asked him like, do I need to use a heat protectant spray? And he was basically telling me that it really just depends on like your hair strands. So I have really thick hair strands, which means that my hair in general are really tough. It just doesn't take damage as easily as people with like thinner hair strands or fine hair. So because I have thick hair strands, like individual strands, as well as a lot of hair, I actually don't need to use a heat protectant spray. You know, I'm not a hairstylist, but I trust my hairstylist so much. I don't think my hair is worse off at all. You know, I think my hair is actually probably the healthiest that it has been in a while, just because I've been simplifying my hair care routine. Yeah, heat protectant sprays, and I don't miss it. So the next hair care product that I used to buy, I was obsessed. Pretty much like with anyone, I think, but dry shampoo. I used to love dry shampoo. You know, when they would come out with like those like kits from like Ulta and Sephora with like a ton of different dry shampoo samples, I was there, you know? I got those for gifts because I was just obsessed with dry shampoo, and I've tried so many dry shampoos out there. At the beginning of quarantine last year, I said to myself, you know what? What would happen if I just stopped using dry shampoo? It was also like kind of part of my quest to, again, simplify my hair routine. I just wanted to use less products in my hair, and I figured, well, dry shampoo is something I could just stop using. So I did, and honestly, I haven't looked back. I think dry shampoo is great if you're like in the training stages of not washing your hair all the time. I've gotten to the point where I only wash my hair every 3 or 4 days. I truly don't need dry shampoo anymore, which is awesome. And my hair, even though it's thick and there's a lot of it, I do have a lot of like product buildup that can occur super easily. So dry shampoo, as crazy as it sounds, I don't buy them anymore. All right, so I'm gonna shift gears now and talk about some makeup products. These products are actually products that I was never actively going out and buying anyway. So I wasn't really using them to begin with. They're also something I just definitely wouldn't spend my money on. That's primers. Face primers, I've never really understood the point of them, to be honest. I think that they're nice for combating like certain issues, like if you have like super oily skin and you want to use like a mattifying primer, like go for it. To be honest, all the primers I've ever tried, they're either like too silicone-y or they like pill underneath my foundation, which kind of like defeats the whole purpose then, and then I have to like start over. Face primers, I definitely think that that's just the makeup product that you don't need. So another makeup product that I've never been that interested in, but I have used before, is color correctors. So I think because I'm someone who doesn't have like super deep set under eye circles or a lot of discoloration that I need to counteract, I've never been drawn to using color correctors. I've used them before. To be honest, I haven't really seen like a big difference in them compared to using like a really high quality concealer or foundation to get the job done. I think color correcting, at least for me, is just not something I never needed. It's just something that I never have in my collection. And then I just have one skincare product that I want to talk about. This is another one of those products that's like dry shampoo. Like I used to buy these all the time. I used to be obsessed with trying like the latest and greatest one to try to find like my perfect one. It is a toner. So toners are kind of like a step in your skincare routine. And like a typical toner, like, you know, you have it in a bottle, you put it on a cotton round and you like kind of rub it around your face, and usually they help like balance the pH of your skin and all that jazz and remove like excess debris. I have not used a toner for about a year now. Honestly, I don't really miss using toners, which is kind of weird because I know like toners are like a big part of like people's routines. And truly, it used to be a big part of my skincare routine as well. I stopped using a toner based on Dr. Loretta's recommendation. So I'm gonna backtrack a little bit here. If you've never heard of Dr. Loretta, she is a board-certified dermatologist, and she has her own skincare line. I actually want to give away from Gloss Angeles, my favorite podcast, by the way. They had a giveaway with her last year and I won it. The giveaway included a Zoom consultation with Dr. Loretta herself. On that call, I was kind of just talking about like my skincare concerns and everything like that. And then she gave me a personalized routine of her products to try for free. And I noticed that in the regimen, there was no toner. So I was kind of asking her about that, and she was explaining to me that, you know, toners were good when they first came out because they were a product that we could use to balance the pH of our skin. But now that science and technology has improved, we've improved our formulations so that we can have a cleanser that can balance the pH and things like that. So we don't really need that extra product in our routine. Like, It's a nice product, but it's definitely not like a necessity product, and she doesn't even have a toner in her own collection. So based on a dermatologist's recommendation, I don't use toners, and I don't really miss toners either. All right, everyone, so I just want to do a really quick recap. So the five beauty products that I don't buy anymore are primers, color correctors, dry shampoo, heat protectant, and toners. I really hope you found this video helpful if you're someone who's like trying to simplify their routine or just kind of looking ways to cut down on their like beauty spending, because I definitely can relate to that. So if you found this video helpful, please give this video a thumbs up and just let me know if this type of like beauty financial video is something that you like to see from me so that I can create more videos like this. And I really just appreciate everyone who takes the time to watch even just like a snippet of this video. I will see everyone in my next video. Bye, everyone.